not. I can literally put them all in a truck with me. That distribution center really doesn't have much. Here we go. My headset just like randomly died. I'm pretty sure it's getting power right now. Actually, you know what? Instead of using this headset, I'm switch to these, which are kind of crappy, but they will work. Not really the surround sound that I like, but it'll work. I'm curious to see how many more times I can go back through this rain with this truck before it completely rusts out. Hey, people are using my post box. That's cool. I'm Sam! I'm also curious to know how many people are on one server. So, like, there's my world, but it's a shared world with other people that I can't actually see, but they can, you know, use post boxes and we can help build roads and stuff. So how many people are actually on one server? Guys got. Oh, here. Let me take that, I guess. I completely forgot I even picked that up.
Hey, Sam. Good to see you. Guys like you make me proud to be part of Bridges. Thank you, Sam. Until the next delivery, then. Stay safe. Good work.
I want all of your things. I got 1,400. Oops. take all your crystals, and I'm gonna take all your ceramics. Well, and all that gets loaded onto the vehicle. I have to go visit the engineer, I think, too. Still have room on this vehicle for more stuff. I don't even think they want any of my stuff anyway. Anything that needs to go to the distribution center, I can do that, but other than that, I got nothing for you. Nope. Taking all your crystals. I'm taking all your ceramics. Later. Oh, come on. There we go. And we're off. Back on the road to make the road. It's not raining through here anymore, so that's cool. What can't you do? Now it is. Dang it, spoke too soon. Truck damaged. Okay. like I said, eventually I thought this thing would tucker out. Apparently I'm getting close to that area. Then I have another truck over in... Hey, the delivery bot completed an order. That's cool. I have another truck over in this third mule area that I left there in favor of this one because the other one was a little bit damaged. But this one now is definitely damaged. Who leaves a vehicle in the middle of the road? Come on. Sleeping tablets to the elder, no thank you, don't care. Now this will be the last road I can make because I have tapped out absolutely everybody. Need to go to South Knot City then and make my delivery. Boom. Build that road, baby. Let's go. Beautiful. Beautiful and magnificent. And I might as well take all these and put them into the next road. Next road is over here. This is awful. Oh wow, this one's already almost completely taken care of. Cool. All I need is metal and crystals. Really not many metals at all, like 200. Not dealing with that nonsense. There are BTs over that way. Happy.
Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Alright. Now let's recycle what we've got on us. They don't have any medals. They have 130. All right. I'm going to take a break right here. I'll be right back. Okay. Oh shoot, there's no crystals, so I can't make that. Oh. The bot got to his location. I'm an expert transporter now. Look at that, my little star is just growing. Okay, so I have to get to the way station, which is where the road I made was going. Ooh, it's fragile cargo, and I also know that's BT territory now, because I went through there pretty much. This is the only problem with taking stuff from all these way stations, is when you need it, kind of screwed. I also don't need anybody's vehicles because I have my own out here.
Have a pleasant journey.
Dude, there's nothing quite like a York peppermint patty, you know? I really enjoy it. Pretty good. And they make me feel like I'm healthy because it's minty flavored.
Weapons restriction lifted.
Don't know whose bike this is. Mine now. I'm pretty sure the way station is right up there. Right through BT territory.
Yep.
Alright, let's see if I can get around this way. Instead of going through BT territory, maybe I can get up through here. Did what I wanted it to do, for sure. Dude, this is like a horse in Skyrim right now. Still BT territory. I'm gonna floor it through this son of a bitch. Hold my beer, watch this. This is fragile cargo too, so not something you really wanna mess around with, but. Oh, did I already go through it? That's cool. That was literally like 2 seconds. BT territory ain't got nothing on me. I think it got hurt in that, even though I did take a pretty hard fall there for a second.
Delivering cargo. Hello. Sam Bridges, right? We've been expecting you. The gauge you brought is going to save a lot of lives. Let me do a quick inspection. Oh. Wonderful. It's in perfect condition. Thank you.
You're welcome. A 1% damage.
Once you connect us to the network, we'll be able to share our measurements with everyone. You mind doing the honors?
Yes, sir. Another region lined up. Ooh, PCC-2 floating carrier. Nice. Ooh, a timefall shelter. And a weather forecast.
I'm sure they told you, but this weather station was built before the Death Stranding.
Bridges 1 came and fixed it up. Unfortunately, we lost contact with our weather satellites a while back. Interference from chiral clouds. So it's been tough to measure chiralium levels and predict timefall. But thanks to you, this weather station can finally function as intended. You made our jobs easier. Now let us do the same for you. We won't let you down, I promise. Take care.
I see you got the weather station back online. Excellent work, Sam. When a region is integrated into the chiral network, it's also brought closer to the beach, in a manner of speaking. There's a significant impact on chiralium levels, and measuring that impact is one of the Cupid's primary functions. The more we know, the more accurately we can determine where to expect timefall and when. Without the chiral network, we'd be left guessing. Oh, and thanks to your latest accomplishment, you can now review the weather forecast via your cufflinks. Check your map. You'll see. Ought to come in handy when you're planning routes. I'll keep an eye on the chiral density from right here in my lab. It's not too far from South Knot City. Keep processing those orders, and you'll put that region on the grid soon enough. Good luck, Sam.
I mean, I'm probably just going to run right through the timefall anyways.
That's one more site on the grid. Keep it up, and we'll be finished before you know it. The weather station's forecast should be visible to everyone on the chiral network now, yourself included. You can access them via your cufflinks. It could be useful when plotting your routes.
I'm literally not going to use that at all.
Good work. New order available. Please access...
These guys have a lot of metal. What's that other one? Ooh, special alloys. That's what it is.
We've added a timefall shelter option to your PCC. They're perfect for keeping you and your cargo dry until the weather improves.
Congratulations, Sam. Your PCC's leveled up, so to speak. It now has the capacity to produce more complex structures. I'll let Mama fill you in on the details.
Sam, I've added a safe house schematic to your PCC. It's a fairly large structure, so it'll take a lot of time and materials to build. But once complete, it's pretty much identical to a private room. Give it a shot.
Okay.
A floating carrier is a kind of tractor car. Chiral crystals keep it suspended in midair, allowing it to move unimpeded over rough terrain. You can load one up with cargo and tow it to your destination with minimal effort. If one's not enough for your needs, you can hook it up to another and take two. Just keep in mind that carriers require a steady supply of chiral crystals to operate. Make sure you have enough to get where you need to go.
Got it. Interesting. Wow. All the way to Lake Knot City? Oh. Okay. Never mind. There are no bots available to take that order. Timefall farm and a construction safe house. Sure.